first of all, Uffie, the squad update, everyone, how are the players, what's the ins and outs looking like?
Everyone's good. Fabio is back training today. Woody joined in early in the week, so he's available as well. Obviously limited with minutes, but the good thing is both Fabio and Woody are back as well.
What's a bit of a bonus with Pat, isn't it? Because we kind of assumed he was gone for the season.
Yeah, well, we were expecting him a week earlier, to be honest. Not a surprise, but yeah, so we've gave him that extra week. He had to tick a few boxes for him to be available, and like I said, he'll be training today and be available for selection for the weekend's game.
How important was it to get the home advantage for the elimination final, considering Allianz last year wasn't necessarily a fortress, but you haven't lost since MacArthur, I think, at Allianz?
Yeah, knock on wood, man. Hopefully that continues. It's nice to get a home final. It's nice to go to our familiar stadium with our fans and have good support. So it was great to get that opportunity to play at home.
The recent form, you were building what looked like to being really one of the form sides, and then you had that week of three games with the trip, Wellington, Perth and Newcastle. Two wins sort of in the last five, is it, or six? Five?
Not sure, mate.
Yeah. Are you worried that the consistency's dropped off a little bit, or is it just been a matter of circumstances with certain games?
Yeah, look, certain games, there's those certain games that you talk about, the Perth travel, we obviously played with 10 men for a long period, even though we were quite comfortable 1-0 up and conceded late. But obviously the travel back to Newcastle probably wasn't our best performance. It's probably been things that we definitely need to improve on in certain parts of the game, and that's something that we've addressed last week leading to Perth, and also this week leading to MacArthur. So the boys know, you know, where we're at, what we need to do, and we're playing against a good side that has beaten us twice so far this season, so they know that it's definitely going to be a challenge.
How have you analysed that defeat to the nine men 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, we looked at you know, obviously the tactical side of things as well, and what we did and what we didn't do well, but also I think it was more so the attitude and the application of the players. I don't think it was there coming off a big game the week before. I thought the players probably thought that it was just going to happen, and these things just don't happen. I think the mentality and attitude needs to be there every single game, and they obviously the boys recognise that if it's not there, this is the outcome that you get.
You've beaten Wellington and the Mariners, the big games, you've shown that you're the derby recently, that you're there. Is there a way of flicking that switch for finals football, or are you confident your squad has what it takes for these big games?
Yeah, we've got the attributes and the players to win games and achieve big things. The boys know that it's not a light switch. That's why it's very important that you can't turn it on and off when you want to, and that's why we need to be 100% focused on every game that we play. And when we haven't, the boys have seen the outcome, and we've seen the outcome of that where we've had that inconsistency. So it's finals football. Anything is possible, but I'm sure the boys will be definitely up for it.
Are you excited for finals football with Yes. Western FC?
Yes, definitely, yes. The aim is to, you know, we want to finish as high as possible. You know, a couple of games where we dropped points probably hindered maybe what we wanted to, maybe get to third at least. But look, we finished in the fourth spot, and it gives us a home final, and we want to continue through the finals.
Having the home final, also a derby against MacArthur, must add a little spice to the game.
Yeah, definitely. I thought there was a little spice in the first game where we played with 10 men, and even then when they played with 9 men. So there was a bit of spice in that game, and I'm sure there would definitely spice this Saturday night as well.
Finishing fourth and I'm in a home final, does that make Sydney FC favourites, would you say?
Yeah, look, finals, it's nice to play in front of our own fans. We'll have that support definitely from our supporters. Look, when it's a one-off game, I think in these one-off games, as long as we're set up tactically right and the boys can execute the game plan well, and then mentally we're 100% focused and try to apply ourselves the best possible way, I think we give ourselves the best chance to get the best outcome. But it's a one-off game, and these finals are football, and everything's possible.
MacArthur, how do you analyse them? I mean, you spoke about your own performance in the recent loss, but they have a couple of really creative players. They also have a lot of pace up front. How do you analyse their strengths?
Yeah, look, they've got one of the best midfielders in the team in Uli Davila that can create something from nothing at times. Jermaine's probably been very consistent for them too this season in assisting and also scoring goals for them. And they've got pace in wide areas with some young players that can take players on. And also, you know, they've got experienced backline with two players that have probably been there, even three, with what's the Kiwi boy's name? Tommy Smith coming in as well. So they've got some really you know, experienced central defenders. And they've got a hard-working midfielder in Clayton that I've worked with previously. And Backus is one that works very hard as well for the team. So, look, they've got experience and a lot of youth and a lot of energy as well. One thing that they do well is transition quite well with the pace that they have. And the way that we play, we're aggressive and we want to defend forward. And at times we'll leave that space as open for them. It's how we nullify those moments when they do win the ball and stop them from being good in those moments.
Just with there's another derby between the Holman siblings. All three are playing, but you've got the boys this weekend. Is that kind of like a talking point going into the weekend?
No, not really. I think the family's going to be split, whether they go down to Melbourne to watch their daughter play or come stay in Sydney and watch their two boys play. So, look, this is football, you know. Siblings end up in different places. I'm sure Corey wants to win and do well for his team, and I'm sure Jakey wants to win and do well for his team. So the focus has been on what we need to do to try to win the game.
Just on that, in terms of the final, the women's grand final being on the same day as the men's elimination final, I know the club's obviously tried to work around it, but I guess from your point of view, do you find that frustrating as well, that fans are potentially split between going to Melbourne and Sydney?
Yeah, look, obviously it does make it difficult. I think you've got to ask Davey's side more so, because they're the ones that are getting stretched, you know, trying to manage a game down in Melbourne, also manage a game here in Sydney. And it's obviously tough for our fans to make that decision too, whether they travel down to support the women to win a grand final or to support the men playing an elimination final. So, look, we don't make the decisions on when games are obviously put in place to where they're going to be played and what time they're going to be played, but it is what it is, and I think the club will deal with it.
We've seen from Dan McArthur kind of never quite beaten. You know, they score a lot of late goals and a lot of, you know, late results, but it's going to be increased even in the finals, isn't it? So do you have to kind of match them mentally, especially towards the end of this game, to survive another week?
Yeah, we've got to match them mentally, we've got to match them physically. That's very important, and I think if we match them in that space, I think we have the quality to shine with the ball. And also if we match them on the defensive side of things, where we're aggressive and we do win balls, I think that'll be great on our side of things. Look, we haven't had a game where, you know, they've scored late. They scored late when we were 10 men, the first game in Sydney. Other than that, the games have been pretty close and pretty tight. But like I said, for us, is the focus on us and make sure we execute the game plan well.